It's my pleasure to be here today with my colleagues to talk about something that I think is critically important at the present moment. Last Wednesday, when the House Environmental Resources and Energy Committee met to consider the amendment to Senate Bill 279 that would result in the abrogation of the Chapter 78 regulations for conventional drilling, we knew that we were going to be facing an onslaught. Those regulations were long in the making. They were subject to 135 days of public comment, 12 public hearings, nearly 30,000 Pennsylvanians weighed in, most of them strongly in favor of increased common sense regulation to safeguard the public and environmental health of the Commonwealth. Yet in the blink of an eye, in the span of less than an hour, the House Environmental Resources and Energy Committee voted to set them aside. 18 people discarded the will of almost 30,000 people who participated in the process. I wish I could say this was an anomaly, but it isn't. Numerous insults to the people and environment of Pennsylvania are now moving quickly through the legislature. My colleagues have spoken today of several of them. Senate Bill 805 would effectively gut the Act 129 Energy Efficiency Program. Senate Bill 1195, now in the House and on today's agenda in committee, would further delay the compliance for the Federal Clean Power Plan. And Senate Bill 562 would muddy the regulatory process with additional unnecessary legislative oversight. The talk surrounding bills such as these often pits people of the eastern half of Pennsylvania against those living in drilling-rich areas, people who support the environment against people who support industry. But from where I stand, that's a false choice. No one wants to destroy an important part of the state's industry. We need the revenue from industry to do what we need to do in Pennsylvania, and we surely have a lot of things to do. But we cannot ignore the fact that the byproducts of these very industries that have made us an industrial giant throughout the world are changing our world. These industries have enriched us, that's for sure, but they also are stealing our health and the pristine water and air we take for granted. The science is in on this. It's not in question. The only question that remains is what we are going to do about it. It is a constitutional imperative for every legislator in this state to safeguard the environmental health and also the resources of the state for us and for the future. Not to sacrifice industry in order to do so, but to work diligently and with an open mind to find a path forward so that our children and grandchildren can continue to enjoy the natural abundance of clean water and clean air that our state has always had. We cannot go back to 2002, the last time the regulations for conventional drilling industry were updated, and where Senate Bill 279 wants to take us. We cannot stand still, which is what Senate Bill 1195 would do by further delaying the compliance plan for the Federal Clean Power Plan. The time is fast approaching when we will have little choice in the matter. A changing climate will wait for no man. It will work to its own calendar. Our job as legislators is to face the current realities and to forge a sensible path forward. Those are the sorts of bills that we need to be moving through the legislature. Instead of trying to turn back the clock, let's talk about transition job bills. Let's talk about renewable energy for all parts of the state, not just the eastern half. Time is growing short. We need to work together for our children and their children who will bear the burden that we face, or we do not face today.